I think in Italy there's a very peculiar situation because working people and left-wing movements were quite satisfied because of the end of the Berlusconi government, and so there was a sort of mood of hope that the new government could somehow get things better than before. And this mood in reality lasts quite a few space of time, because this new government, which is named a technical no politics government, in reality is going on with quite ferocious attack against conquest of the working class in Italy that nobody ever did before. For example, one of the most important things is that they decide the so-called labor reform, in which they approved this reform in which it is possible to sack people without justifications. It was in Italy it was quite a famous point of defense of the working movement, conquered in the 1970, which is the 18th article of the labor law, conquered in the 1970. And in all these past decades, all the government tried to destroy this conquest, and nobody managed to do that. And 10 years ago, for example, there were demonstrations with millions of people organized by the CGIL and working movement won. They didn't manage. And with the crisis, the European crisis, and this new technical government, they managed to win these things without 1 hour of strike. This gives you the idea of the sense of impotence of a layer, above all, of active people, the delegates, that they see that there is a mood of shock, above all, among people who were active in the working class movement, youth movement, in the last years, because of the crisis, because of the fact that we have this technical government which is supported by right-wing parties and also so-called left parties, in particular the Democratic Party, which is quite connected with the CGIL, which is the main union, as you know, in Italy. But the fact is that, as a matter of fact, the working class conditions and the youth conditions are worsening quite a lot. We have a very dramatic situation, above all among the youth, something like 36% of unemployment among the youth, and in the south of the country, one youth out of two is unemployed, so it's a very quite dramatic situation. We have closures of factories, and many working people is at home because there are crises into many factories, particularly Fiat, which was the workers of Fiat were at the forefront of the struggle in 2010 and 2011, and now they are at the defense because of the crisis. So it's a very peculiar situation in which all the leaders of the so-called left-wing parties, also you must take into account that we have no political representation of the Communist Party, of the Green Party, since 2008, and so there is a sort of situation in which the workers' movement feels themselves somehow without a leader, without a head, how can I say? And So this gives the situation a very unstable situation, because there is a growing mood of fury because of the concrete conditions of working people, and at the same time the lack of leadership, how organize a response to this attack and to the crisis. So in these months we saw very strong struggles in some part of the country which were not connected on a national scale, among the immigrants, among the most exploited workers, who organized themselves also in unofficial unions. For example, in the last months we had a very, very hard struggle among the workers of the logistic sectors, which is a quite important sector because it is linked to the private transport of goods all over the country, and these immigrants are employed to charge trucks, and so if they stop to work they create a great damage to the bosses. And we saw very hard struggle among these layers just to apply the official bargaining signed by the official union. So it was a defensive, a so-called defensive struggle, but they had a very hard character, because these workers were very exploited. Most of them are immigrants, they don't know Italian, and so the bosses give them, for example, half of the wages out of official agreement, without paying taxes and so on. They were an example for a whole layer of activists, because they were brutally repressed by the police, and among a layer of youth and working people, they were a point of reference. For example, they tried to connect to the railway workers who were sacked, some of them, on a national scale. These railway workers, to defend their jobs, went on a tower and in Milano and in Rome. They stayed all the winter on this tower, 50 meters over the ground. So it was a quite somehow testimonial struggle, but very difficult in winter conditions. And these immigrant workers tried to connect with them, to trying to go out of the isolation in which the bureaucracy of the official union tried to put them. And so we saw this kind of struggle in which a whole layer of activists are learning from their experience how to fight in a very hard way against the bosses, and also against the reformist bureaucracy, who are paralyzed by the crisis and by the government and by the necessity of the reformist party to wait for the next election and the change of the Italian political scene. Another important struggle, which was a point of reference for a whole layer of the working people and the youth, was the struggle in Valsusa against the high-speed train. It was incredible, because for a whole space of time it was the only struggle which attracted a lot of people. Let's say that in Valsusa it's a mountain valley, quite industrialized. It has 30,000 inhabitants, and on February They had a demonstration about 30,000 people, and almost all the people of the valley was in demonstrations, occupying the mountains, the paths, and of course there were many people all of Italy, completely auto-organized, because no party, no unions organized free pullman, free buses, free trains, and so this shows the necessity, the mood of the people, the desire to have a proper struggle against the crisis, against the government. It is clear that there is a mood of fury among people, among the working people. And I think that next autumn we will have a quite hot autumn, because the government is going on with their attacks after the approval of this labor reform. They decide a new attack. They say that it was not a cut in welfare state, but they decide something like 24,000 cuts in welfare state, which means sackings in the public sector. Now the CGIL organized for 28th of September a general strike of the public employees, and they are forced to do that because there is a growing mood of working people to give a proper answer against this, and they cannot maintain this situation of calm, of lull. It is not possible anymore. On last September, CGIL organized a strike on the 6th of September, soon after the end of the Italian holidays. And in reality, an important layer of workers were not at work. For example, education workers, because public school starts at the mid of September, because they try to do something the earliest possible, not to disturb the government. But I think that 1 year lasts, and it is not possible to maintain this situation. And another important fact is the situation that Italian working people see all over Europe, in Greece, in Spain. And they understand that Italy is not outside this landscape of class struggle.
It must be added that in the last years, both left-wing government and right-wing government brutally attacked the public education in Italy, university and high schools, reducing teachers, professors, and also reducing financement. So I think that the public education in Italy was students and teachers were quite proud of public education in Italy. It was extremely much better than private education. After these reforms of the last years, I think that for the first time in Italy since the 60s, the 70s, many parents, many families think that if they want their children have a proper education, perhaps they must choose private school. So this is a very impact, this shows the effect. We had a movement in 2008 against the cut of the Berlusconi government. It was a very extremely wide movement all over the country, with thousands of people in the streets, but that movement failed. And after the movement, the defeat had the effect to how can you say? It had the effect to stop further movements in the year later. For example, last autumn we saw some demonstrations by a few thousands of people.
But we saw that above all with the young, very young people, there is a growing mood of fury because of things that happen, because students that are about 15, 16 years start to look around and see just crises and demonstrations against governments all over. In the Arab world, in United States, in Spain, in Greece. And it is, we saw this in demonstrations, for example, in Valsusa. It was full of very young people. And so we think that probably next autumn we will have also a bigger movement among the high school students, probably more than the university movement.